Thank you very much. It's difficult to take the floor after a Lutz presentation, but I try to do my best. I want to start saying that when I saw the title of my presentation, I said, wow, this is quite a challenge. There are so many aspects in only one topic. So I try to summarize the most important aspects linked with this technology trends for an agile and sustainable closing production system. So, taking into consideration the impact of the fashion industry, there is an urgent need that both innovation and technology to enable the transformation of the industry from a linear to a more circular business model. According to the most recent trend reports, we can see that technology has a central role in accelerating this shift to circularity. This fast-moving industry, still considered a low-tech one, can be disrupted by an agile approach, a paradigm for the future industrial organization. And when we look at the entire apparel global value chain, we can see that production is situated at the lowest value added stage, and I hope that in the future this situation will change. So the main trends that are transforming the fashion value chain are presented in this slide, and I want only to emphasize important aspect Lutz mentioned also about digitalization of the value chain. Regarding the agility, an agile company is one that is able to operate profitably in a competitive environment, which is characterized by this unpredictable changing in customer requirements. The organizations that are agile customer-oriented plan their processes, products, and services according to iterative models instead of waterfall ones. So the agile company aligned their entire strategy with the customer needs. We have to think about the reorientation to an agile thinking of and the behavior, which bring decisive strategic competitive advantages for the companies. So the agile processes, for short, are iterative and incremental, and the smart and agile manufacturing is seen as a key concept of the companies in the context of the fourth industrial revolution. So speed and agility will characterize the winning apparel place, and in this context, I want to emphasize also that automation could play an important role in achieving a circular value chain. Regarding the Industry 4.0, it is a new stage in the organization and management of the entire value chain. And it can extend from the design, development, production to upcycling and even associated business services. Regarding the fourth industrial revolution, is an era where electronics and information technology enable the complete digital connectivity, and the interaction between some important revolutionary technologies are changing the very nature of the enterprise value chain. And the manufacturing sector is a revolution in making in this context of Industry 4.0. Regarding the factories of the future, this will be completely automated, self-servicing, self-repairing structures, and require a minimal human intervention. The production and manufacturing processes can be replicated on a digital platform in a virtual environment, and the main results, I can summarize that, are a more efficient and agile system, less production downtime, greater ability to predict and adjust to the changes. A smart factory is connected, optimized, transparent, proactive, and agile. And how does the factory of the future look like? I want to mention only the most important factors like flexible manufacturing and agile processes. So the main characteristic of the factory of the future will be the hyper efficiency. Regarding the sustainability, I just want to mention that sustainable production means the manufacturing of products and product inputs and the creation of related services that respond to consumer and market needs, minimizing in the same time the use of natural resources and toxic materials. So technology and innovation can accelerate the value creation, but this means to shape a vision of production that can promote economic growth and innovation in an inclusive and sustainable manner. And to take into consideration that some emerging technologies are at different stages of technical readiness and adoption. Such as 3D printing, advanced robotics that are have a longer industrial history. Regarding the converging technologies that can create value, the main important technologies are presented in this slide. And I will start with the Internet of Things. That is presented as a revolution, but actually is an evolution of technologies over a period of 15 years. So the opportunities for Internet of Things for producers lies in smart enterprise control, asset performance management in real time, smart and connected products and services. It is also a philosophy as her potential lies in the ability to link automation system with enterprise planning, scheduling and product life cycle system. And very important that Internet of Things and robotics represent the next level of integrated sensors into robotic systems. Artificial intelligence and machine learning are other important emerging technologies. Artificial intelligence enables producers to transform the overwhelming data into meaningful decisions. The most promising opportunities for applying these technologies are in production system are in quality management, predictive maintenance, and supply chain optimization. While machine learning allows a computer application or program to recognize and learn from different patterns in data and to improve capabilities without the human intervention. Both technologies play a crucial role in delivering personalized experiences. Enterprise wearables, I mentioned here augmented and virtual reality. In the specific case of production, they could enable people to thrive and harness their capabilities more fully. And they present valuable use cases, for instance, for quality inspection, work instruction, training, workflow management, operations and safety, logistic and maintenance. Advanced robotics have handled the dull, dirty, and dangerous jobs, and currently they can automate around 10% of the production tasks. They were separated from people for safety reasons, but with a new generation of robots, they work alongside humans. In this slide, you can see the image of the t-shirt sewing robot that can radically shift the apparel industry. 3D printing or additive technologies is also increasingly being adopted for industrial use. It is revolutionary due to its ability to complement traditional manufacturing processes and transform the design, product design, and create also new values. 3D printing works best, as you know, where customization is very important. And now is transitioning from rapid prototyping to scaled production for certain products. You can see in this slide the main impacts of the 3D printing technology in the fashion industry. And I emphasize the manufacturing area, integrating direct digital manufacturing. So technology innovation is a must for the development of circular business models. These emerging technologies will allow organizations to create value in the circular economy. And we have to think at digital, physical, and or biological technologies. Another important aspect is the prospect of automation for the apparel manufacturing, but the companies need to have a detailed understanding of the technology landscape. For this, a broad screening throughout the apparel production process was made, and were identified five key automation technologies, namely automation of sewing and logistics, gluing, bonding, knitting, and finishing. Regarding sewing, we know that is the most labor-intensive step in producing a garment and accounts more than half of the total labor time per garment. The potential to reduce the labor depends on product type and design, and up to 90% of the sewing of simple garments can be automated. As an example, here you see software automation, which is currently on the forefront of fully automated sewing. Intralogistics and warehousing are the next most labor-intensive part of the apparel production processes. Robotics in intralogistics throughout the production process can halve labor-intensive, reduce processing time and errors, and improve workers' economy. Regarding the technologies available today, I can mention overhead garment on hanger system to store, sort, and pick display-ready garments, and self-driving warehouse vehicles. Gluing and bonding will allow companies to completely bypass the sewing, adding in the same time functionality to some performance garments. Combined with robotics, this technology has the potential to significantly reduce labor and increase the production speed. Knitting, the advanced technologies such as 3D knitting enable customization, improve design and fit. And I gave you the example of Nike's Flyknit production line that uses a computerized knitting processes that has reduced material waste with 18%. Regarding finishing, I mean automated finishing like digital printing lasers, which are fast, low cost, and require little labor. For instance, digital printing can reduce labor up to 70% and abrasives up to 90%. I gave here another example, Levi's laser technology that drastically cuts the finishing time for a pair of jeans from 20 minutes to 90 seconds. It is very important also to see the economic viability of automation. So we have to assess the automation technologies across the entire cut, make, trim, and finishing processes. We can see that in several of the production steps, innovative technologies have not been yet broadly implemented. These show the potential in the future. And in this slide, you can see that sewing is the most complex step to automate in this cut, make, and trim process. This is a jeans example. So technology advancements have pushed automation in apparel manufacturing, will define the future of production system, and these advances can create green, clean, equitable, and sustainable systems. But this means in the same time for the successful transformation to build skills and change mindset, so we have to rethink the entire apparel value chain and to build the right ecosystem of partners, because players will not be able to go alone in the future. So building an ecosystem of partners will be the key in creating competitive advantages, sustainable competitive advantages. And also the brands have to collaborate with technology companies to develop this innovative solution, because currently neither apparel brands nor most of the manufacturers are in the position to develop these disruptive technologies. So we have to think also of the open ecosystem that goes to open platforms that are able enable a complete digital ecosystems that will continue to evolve. So we have to create an ecosystem that is mutually beneficial for all the partners. And finally, we have to take into consideration that all these technology advancements are coming with significant environmental costs. So we have to evaluate their impact to be sure that economic profits are anchored to social benefits for people and the planet. So just to say a final statement, sustainable production aims to do more and better with less. Thank you very much for your attention.